All right, Coach G, endowment meet. You guys are 1-1 on the day. You know, talk about your thoughts. You know, excellent showing against the Badgers of Wisconsin, I thought, and then subpar against the Broncos of Boise State. What are your thoughts on the Wisconsin match first off?
Well, Wisconsin, I thought we wrestled okay. You know, I thought even some of the places we won, we could have done better. You know, Wisconsin got some tough kids, you know, 49-pound Rochelle and Howell at 65 are tough guys. But, you know, I felt overall, you know, sometimes, you know, our program just beating Big Ten teams, a step in the right direction. But I think, you know, I thought we could have wrestled better at some individual matchups.
Okay. 2-0 on the day, Jason Lara and Clayton the Jackhammer. Talk about their performance and, you know, how those two guys are going to have to emerge as leaders for you.
Well, you do. I mean, like Jason Lara actually set the tone for us every match. You like to have a guy set the tone when they step on the mat. He's that type of kid. He's explosive. He's fiery. You know, I think he's a guy that's going to get better and better as that year goes on. And if he gets better on the mat, he's one of those guys he'll be in every match. Jack, you know, coming off that knee injury last year, looked pretty good. You know, he's only been wrestling hard for 3 weeks now. So, I mean, he once he gets his conditioning and the timing down, I think he'll get better and better.
Okay, Boise match, completely disappointing for you, I believe. I heard you talking in there to the fall club and, you know, the people who came over here to Reeser afterwards. But talk about, you know, some things that you think you guys need to do to change that outcome, because you guys go home and home against them. You got a chance against them this year.
Yeah.
In a duel. What do you guys got to do? What do you got to change?
Well, you see a lot of things. It's good for us to see them guys early because, you know, they're a team in the Pac-10 to beat. And they're a good team, but they beat us on basics, you know, basic just positions. And if you get beat on the basic positions, you're usually going to get beat. And that's what they beat us on, just hand fighting positions on our head too much. And they beat us on, you know, on riding a little bit. So, I mean, we know we got to get better. And I thought we gave a couple matches just away, you know, trying too big of moves, you know, just not staying basic ourselves. So it's one of those things, it's a good learning experience. You know, we'll see them down the road. And it's good to have that tough competition for our team this time of year.
Okay, RJ Pena had a rough day, and Mike Bagram went 1-1, and it was their debut in Oregon State Singleton on your campus. What are you going to say to guys like that? Hey, you know, they've had nothing but success their entire careers, and maybe they took a lump or two today. You know, what do you say to guys like that?
Well, it's college wrestling. It's a big step up. So to me, man, you know, like a guy like Mangrum, you know, he's trying for, like, okay, I can come back and throw a move that's maybe not a high percentage move that maybe worked in high school, but this level doesn't work. You know, maybe he's trying to pin the guy, which I like. But you know, you got to when you get behind, you got to come back. You know, basically get your escape, get your 2-point takedown, which I don't feel he did that. You know, he was going looking for a big move. RJ just, you know, he was on the legs, he's on attacks. You know, he just has to get better at finishing. He's hesitating too much on his finishes. You know, he's getting to the legs, but he's got to learn how to finish.
And, you know, him having guys like Chamberlain and Rochelle, I mean, those are guys he's got to beat, you know, if he wants to go to the next level. But that's probably not the greatest slate to have here in your opening match as a true freshman, right?
Well, you only had one way. One, you worry about a guy who's going to lose his confidence. But a guy like RJ, you know, talking to him earlier in the week, you know, he wanted to wrestle those guys. He's one kind of guy that when he gets beat, he'll go back to the drawing board and learn how to get better and try to beat those guys. So, you know, what I like about him is he's going to go back and work harder and he's going to get better as the year goes on.
Okay, Jim, what's next for you guys?
You know, we got this week, we're going to wrestle Simon Fraser, which is a Canadian school, and, you know, Pacific, which is a Division III school out here. You know, kind of a warm-up, tune up before we go to Vegas in a couple weeks. But wrestle those guys next Sunday, and then we'll go to Vegas, which will be a good test individually for us. You get to see a lot of individuals there and kind of test out where we are that way.
Okay, last thing I'm going to ask you. Do you guys not get enough respect out here in the West? You beat the 13th-ranked team today, I believe, 7-3. Do you guys not get enough respect in the rankings?
Well, I think you look at the West, and right now I think Pac-10's been down a little bit, but I think we're coming up. I thought we were coming up. You know, the Pac-10, I think Stanford beat a couple of Big Ten teams. I think Cal Poly just beat Missouri. So it's one of those things where I think, you know, our conference is coming up this year, and you like to see that. But it's at Nationals when it really counts. But it's good to see the West Coast team doing well, because we need to do well just to have that presence in wrestling.
All right, Jim. Hey, thank you for the time. And 3,000+ people here at the endowment meet, so probably a success.
No, it's a success. Anytime you get 3,000 people to wrestle meet, you know, and in the past we've built, you know, we haven't been that good lately. So I think as you keep getting better, the more successful you are, you know, the more people are going to come watch you.
All right, Jim, thanks for the time.
Thank you.